Morning students,
we have started the hydrides of group 15, which is of the P block. And students, according to the recent we can say modification in the syllabus, the P block belongs to the unit 7, though the number will be coming unit 6, but the sequence they have kept the same, right? Sequence and the number of the unit is being kept same. Earlier I was writing unit 6, right? But now I'm correcting it. It is unit 7, right? That is P block element. And accordingly, the D block element, D and F block element will be unit 8, and the coordination compound will be unit 9. So please get it corrected in your class notebook, right? Now we are beginning with the characteristics of the hydrides of the group 15. Now students, we have in the last class mentioned that the hydrides of the group 15, right, they are ammonia, phosphine, arsine, stibine and bismuthine. These are the hydrides of group 15, right? Now first we will discuss the structure of these hydrides. The first point to be kept in mind is the hybridization which these hydrides undergoes. So they all are sp3 hybridized, right? So these hydrides will contain 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. Among these, the 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals will form a bond with 1s orbital of hydrogen, and 1 sp3 hybrid orbital will contain the lone pair. So it is sp3 hybridized and has a lone pair single lone pair is there in one of the sp3 hybrid orbital. Right, student? So, since it is sp3 hybridized, expected shape to be tetrahedral right, so due to lone pair, or we can say the actual shape will get distorted from tetrahedral due to presence of the lone pair, right? So the shape is now distorted to pyramidal shape. Right, this is because of the lone pair bond pair repulsion. Right, students? So this is there. Now the next thing comes about the bond angle. So the bond angle of ammonia, which is 107.8 degree, right? So it is 107.8 degree. This is the bond angle of the ammonia. Now when the students move down the group, what will happen? The bond angle is going to increase or decrease, right? So you have to think of it, that what will happen if we just move down the group, what is going to be the effect on the bond angle. Now let us first draw the structure of it. So one of the sp3 hybrid orbital, this is the shape of ammonia, and one of the sp3 hybrid orbital contains the lone pair, similarly the other contains the bond pair with that of the hydrogen, right? So when we move down the group, students, the bond angle is going to decrease, right? So the bond angle of hydrides decreases on moving down the group right, and this is because due to increase in, so when we move down, hydrogen is common students in all, so what is happening in moving down the group, the size of the atom, that is of the group 15 elements, it is going to increase. So what will happen students, then the bond length is going to increase down the group, right? So if the bond length increases down the group, so what will happen, the distance between the two bond pairs is also going to increase down the group, so there will be less repulsion between the bond pair, right? So students, before we just continue it, let me first complete the increase in atomic size down the group, right? So what will happen, so nitrogen size is smaller students, right? So the bond pair of this bond, right, it will be closer toward the nitrogen. Similarly here also it will be closer toward the nitrogen here also, so there will be, we can say these bond pairs will be nearer to one another and hence the repulsion will take place. But as the size is going to increase, what will happen students, definitely the bond length is increasing. If the bond length will increase student, so that time what is going to happen, phosphorus be bigger in size, right? It will not pull the shared electron pair more toward itself, it will, right? So what will happen, there will be less repulsion between these two bond pairs, right? So due to the smaller atomic, as due to the increase in atomic size down the group, right? So here we can say that as a result, the bond pair around central atom are not closer enough to show greater repulsion, right? Hence bond angle decreases, right students? So you can just simply, instead of this, you can also write that with the increase in atomic size and decrease in the electronegativity, the shared electron pair will be less attracted toward the central atom. As a result, the two shared electron pair, they will undergo or experience less repulsion, hence the bond angle is going to decrease, right? And in ammonia, since it is smaller in size, higher electronegativity, the shared electron pair, they are pulled more closer to the nitrogen atom, and hence there is repulsion between the bond pair, and hence the bond angle increases. This is about the bond angle. It is one of the characteristic of the hydrides, right? Now the next characteristic of the hydride is the basic strength. Now students, you know that the basic strength is related, since these hydrides or these compounds have got a lone pair on the central atom, so we will relate their basic strength from their electron pair donating tendency, right? The second characteristics which we are going to discuss is the basic strength. Now students, here the all the hydrides, right, So I'm writing the hydrides again: ammonia, phosphine, arsine, stibine, and bismuthine. All these hydrides have got a lone pair on the central atom, right? So due to presence of lone pair on central atom, they are Lewis base. So they all are Lewis base due to presence of lone pair on central atom. Now students, they all are bases, but which one is among them more stronger base? Now it will depend upon the tendency of it to donate the lone pair, right? Greater the tendency to donate the lone pair, greater will be the greater is the strength to be as a Lewis base, right? So among this, the stronger base is ammonia, right? So the electron donating tendency is maximum in ammonia and decreases down the group. Right? So how can we explain it, that electron donating tendency is maximum in ammonia and it decreases down the group? How can we explain this point? So for that, students, here the nitrogen atom, it is smaller in size, right? This lone pair will be pulled or will be under the influence of the central atom, that is nitrogen, right? So we can say here that due to smaller size of nitrogen, the electron density of lone pair is more concentrated on nitrogen atom, right? And hence the tendency to donate it is maximum in nitrogen. So since the lone pair, though all the elements have got the lone pair on them, but since the lone pair, it is more concentrated on nitrogen atom because of its smaller size. Nitrogen atom is smaller size, and down the road the size is going to increase. So the electron density concentration will be more on nitrogen. In phosphorus, it will be little diffused. Here it will be more diffused, and then as the same way, it is going to be scattered or dispersed down the group. So what will happen, students, if it is more concentrated on nitrogen atom, right? So whenever the ammonia will be in contact of a Lewis acid, right, that electron cloud will be, of the electron cloud of a lone pair, will be available near the nitrogen atom to get it donated to the Lewis acid, right, students? And hence ammonia is a stronger base because the electron density of the lone pair is maximum on the nitrogen atom. We are going to discuss about the thermal stability of the hydrides, right? So on moving down the group from ammonia to bismuthine, the stability toward the heat is going to decrease, right? So among this series, the most stable toward the heat is ammonia, and then on moving down the group, the stability decreases. Now the thermal stability, it is going to depend upon the students, the strength of the covalent bond, and that in turn depend upon the bond length, right, students? So here the thermal stability on moving down the group, you can see it is going to decrease, and this is why, because on moving down the group, down the group, the size of central atom increases, and hence the bond length E dash H also increases. As a result, the strength of covalent bond decreases down the group. Right, students? So if the strength of the covalent bond will decrease, the strength of covalent bond decreases down the group. So if the strength will decrease, then less amount of heat is sufficient to break the bond, right? And hence the molecule will become less stable. Right, students? I think this point is clear to you. The thermal stability is related with the bond enthalpy, which in turn is related with the bond length, right? So if the bond length will increase on moving down the group, the strength of the covalent bond is going to decrease, and hence less amount of heat is sufficient to break the covalent bond, right? Now, related to this, that is related to the thermal stability, we have the reducing character, right? So on next characteristic which we are going to discuss is the reducing nature . Now the reducing nature, student, is going to depend upon the thermal stability of the molecules, right? So on reducing nature, right? So we are talking about here E dash H bond. Now on moving down the group, we have discussed that the thermal stability is going to decrease, right? That means the bismuthine is least thermally stable. Now through the reducing nature, that is to get the hydrogen provided, right, is going to increase down the group. So this sequence will get reversed, right? So this reducing nature, it is related with thermal stability. Since the thermal stability decreases down the group, the reducing nature of hydrides increases down the group. Hence, bismuthine has highest reducing nature, right? So the reducing nature is going to depend upon the thermal stability, that the availability of the hydrogen atom during the process, and that will depend upon the strength of the covalent bond. Now moving down the group, students, we know that the strength is going to decrease, right? And hence we will say that the reducing nature is going to increase. Now, student, the next characteristic which we are going to discuss is the boiling point and melting point. Now students, you know that the boiling point is associated with the van der Waal forces between the molecules, right? So here it is found that the van der Waal forces, it depends upon the molecular size. So as the molecular size will increase, the boiling point is also going to increase. So students, on moving down the group, what is expected? That the boiling point should increase on moving down the group, right? So accordingly, the bismuthine will have highest boiling point, right? And ammonia will have the lowest boiling point. And if we compare the two boiling point of ammonia and phosphine, the phosphine is having higher boiling point than ammonia. So students, here we have to make a point that the other members, they will follow the sequence according to the van der Waal forces. But ammonia, student, it is smaller in nitrogen atom, smaller in size, high electronegativity. Hence, it has got a tendency to form the hydrogen bond with itself. So, due to presence of the intramolecular hydrogen bond between the ammonia molecule, it has got the higher boiling point than phosphine, right? So the boiling point of ammonia is higher than phosphine because of the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bond, right? So we are just going to mention here, the boiling point of ammonia is higher than phosphine due to presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding in ammonia, which is absent in other hydrides. Right? Whereas from phosphine onward, boiling point increases due to increase in van der Waal forces, which depends upon molecular size, right? So this is related with the boiling point, right? And the melting point of these hydrides also show the same trend, right students? So the hydrides, which one has got the maximum boiling point? That is the bismuthine, right? And if we compare the two, ammonia and phosphine, the ammonia has got the higher boiling point. So the bismuthine has got maximum boiling point, right? So the next characteristics we are going to discuss is the solubility of the hydrides. Now students, you know that the solubility of a hydride in water will depend upon which factor? It will depend upon the tendency of it to form the hydrogen bond, intermolecular hydrogen bond with water, right? So the next characteristic is the solubility, right, of hydrides in water due to ability of forming intermolecular hydrogen bond with water, ammonia is soluble in it, whereas rest of the hydrides are insoluble in water, right? And this is an important key of the solubility here, that we have to relate with the with the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, the intermolecular hydrogen bonding between the ammonia and the water, right? They undergo association, hence they are soluble. Ammonia is soluble in water, whereas the rest members, since they are bigger in size and the electronegativity decreases down the group, they have no tendency to form the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, right, students? So it is still here that we have discussed the characteristics in the hydrides. We have discussed the formation, how we can prepare the hydride. We have discussed the structure of the hydrides, that the hydrides, they have got pyramidal shape, right, undergo the sp3 hybridization, and they have got a lone pair. Next, we discuss the basic strength. Due to presence of this lone pair only, they are show the basic nature. We have discussed the thermal stability, bond angle, thermal stability, reducing nature. Thermal stability and reducing nature are related to one another, followed by the melting, boiling point and melting point, and at the last we covered the solubility. So students, get it, all the things noted down in your notebook, right? Good morning, students. In our last class, we have discussed the hydrides of the nitrogen family. Now, today we are going to discuss the halides of group 15 elements. Now, students, the halides of group 15 form is of two types. First is PX3 and PX5. Now, students, here the X stands for the halogen fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, and E stands for the element nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. Now, the trihalides. So first we are going to discuss the trihalides of nitrogen family. All the members of this group form the trihalides, right? So all the members forms trihalides of PX3 type. That means nitrogen will also form the trihalide, right? Similarly, the phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. Now, student, exception lies here, that NX3. Here, the NF3 which is formed is the stable compound, right? Whereas NCl3 is highly formation, is highly exothermic, and rest of the nitrogen halides are also very, very reactive, and hence they are unstable. So this is the only NF3 which is going to form a stable compound. right? So why the rest of the nitrogen halides are unstable? The reason is that the N-dax X bond, that is the covalent bond between the nitrogen and the halogen, the bond length, right? Here there is a large difference in their atomic sizes, hence the bond is not formed, right? So due to greater difference in atomic size of nitrogen and chlorine, bromine and iodine, right, the bond is unstable. Right, whereas if we take N dash F students, here the we can say the atomic size of nitrogen and chlorine is comparable, right, and hence the bond is being formed, right? So we can say here that the bond between nitrogen and chlorine is formed because of small difference in the size, right? Nitrogen is 75 picometer and that of fluorine is 72 picometer, right? So among these halides, nitrogen NF3 is a stable compound, whereas rest of the halides of nitrogen family are unstable, right? And other members of this group, they form the halides EX3, ASX3, FBX3 and BIX3, and almost all the halogen atoms will be involved here, right? Now student, next we will discuss here the structure of the halides which are being formed, right? So the halides, the nitrogen atom or the these elements, they undergo the, so we have the next important thing that you have to discuss is the structure, right? So for that hybridization, you have to go through that the hybridization shown by the trihalides is sp3, right? So they are four sp3 hybrid orbitals. So out of four sp3 hybrid orbitals, three forms covalent bond with p orbitals of halogens. Now the halogens, how many halogen atoms are getting involved students? Here it is three, so there are 3x atoms, right? And one sp3 hybrid orbital which is left contains a lone pair, right? So okay, it's okay. So it is left contains a lone pair, right? So sp3 hybridization, the shape should be a tetrahedral, but due to presence of a lone pair, the shape gets distorted and it is pyramidal shape. So if we take, this is E, here it is one halogen atom, this is the another halogen atom, this is the third, and here we have got a lone pair, right? So the shape formed is pyramidal in shape, Right, students. So this is about the structure of the halides. Right, now if I just write down the bond, the sequence for the bond angle of the trihalides. Right, so let us take for phosphorus here. Right, so can you predict the bond angle that which halide of phosphorus will have higher bond angle, student? So it is Pi3. Right, so the bond angle for the halides of phosphorus is smaller for the PF3, and then it gradually increases as the, we can say, as the size of the halogen atom increases. So can you just predict that why it will be so? So here we know that the central atom is common here, so the halogen atoms, right, so the electronegativity decreases down the group. Right, students, so fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, right? And second thing, the important thing you will see here, that the bond length is also going to increase on moving down the group, and the electronegativity is decreasing down the group. So these both are going to affect, right, the bond angle. Right, students, so it's just a small question to you that you have to just try to solve this question, that why does the bond angle follow the above sequence. Hope so, students, you can answer it now, that why this sequence is being followed here. So PF3, right, fluorine is here the electronegative element, most electronegative element. So what will happen, student, the shared electron pair will be pulled more toward the halogen atom. As a result, what will happen, the two bond pair, right, they are going to be more toward the electronegative element. So what will happen, there will be minimum repulsion. But when we talk about the iodine, it is less electronegative, so it will not pull the shared electron pair toward itself. As a result, the bond pair will be closer to one another, and hence the repulsion is going to increase. Right, so here the answer is due to the decrease in electronegativity down the group, the BP repulsion increases, and hence bond angle increases. Right, students, now the next is, after the students, in our last class we discussed the trihalides of the group 15 elements. Today we are going to discuss the nature of the trihalides, that is the acid or a base nature. So generally the trihalides of the group 15 elements, they act as a Lewis acid, except that of the nitrogen, right? The halides of the nitrogen members are acting as a Lewis base. Why is it so? Because due to the absence of the vacant d orbitals in them, right? So, and let's see first here that we have got nitrogen trifluoride, trichloride, tribromide and Ni3. Now, students, a question can arise that why it is acting as a Lewis base. Student, the lone pair on the nitrogen atom, right? It has been pulled by the, we can say, by the fluorine atom, which is the electronegative element attached to it. As a result, it is not readily available for donation, and hence it get a positive, partial positive charge on it. As a result, it is going to pull the electron cloud of the nearby atom, right? So NF3, NCl3, NBr3, Ni3. Now, as we move down the group, students, halogens, right, the size of atom is going to increase. As a result, the electronegativity is also going to decrease. So the tendency to pull the electron cloud of the lone pair on the, or you can say to pull the electron cloud of lone pair on nitrogen atom toward itself is also going to decrease. Yes, so that's why the Lewis base, that is tendency to attract the electron pair from the surrounding atom, is also going to decrease. So hence the Lewis base, if we just compare that of the trihalides of nitrogen family, so here the electronegativity difference of the halogens, right, we can say Lewis base strength of the trihalides of nitrogen is going to increase as the electronegativity of the halogen atom is going to decrease, right, students? So I have just got this arranged in a wrong order. So just you will compare that as the electronegative element is present, so what will happen, student? There is a strong tendency to withdraw the electron from nitrogen. As a result, the nitrogen atom acquires partial positive charge, and hence the tendency to donate the electron pair is going to decrease, right? So the sequence which I have arranged was as a Lewis acid, but here, since the electronegativity, student, is going to decrease down the group, so tendency to pull the lone pair toward itself is going to decrease. Hence, the positive charge, partial positive charge on the nitrogen atom is going to decrease, right? So the Lewis base strength is going to increase in this order, right? So we can write down here that nitrogen halides acts as a Lewis base due to the first is absence of vacant d orbital, and second is bonded to electronegative element, which withdraw, we can say, tends to withdraw its lone pair toward it, right? So here this is about the nitrogen, and what about the other halides of this group, right? So if we just, and other halides, that is the rest of the element halides, act as a Lewis acid, right, students? The rest of the element halides act as a Lewis acid, and that will be due to the availability of vacant d orbitals which can accept electron pair from surrounding atom. Right, so the rest of the halides, they will form act as a Lewis acid. So let us compare the strength of trihalides of phosphorus. Right, this is phosphorus trifluoride, trichloride, tribromide, and triiodide. Now, students, here why it is acting as a Lewis acid? Because the lone pair or the phosphorus will be pulled toward the will be pulled by the electronegative element. As a result, a partial positive will arise, charge will arise, right? And it is going to pull the electron toward it, right? In case of the nitrogen, there also it was arising, but due to absence of d orbitals, it was not able to act as a Lewis base. But in this case, they have got the vacant d orbital to accept the electron pair, so they act as a Lewis acid. Right, so here the tendency to induce the partial positive charge will be more in fluorine, so it will be PF3, PCl3, PBr3 and Pi3. Now student, these type of topics you get generally the conceptual questions, or either a series will be arranged and you will be asked, acids will be given and you will be asked to arrange them in a increasing or a decreasing order of the acidic strength. Now students, we are going to discuss about the pentahalides of this group. Now it forms the EX5 type of pentahalides. All the elements will form the pentahalides except the nitrogen. So except nitrogen, rest of the elements forms pentahalides, right? Thus, and why is it so? Again, due to absence of d orbital. Right, you know that nitrogen doesn't contain a d orbital in it, so that's why. So it will be not, since it is not available, so it will not be vacant also. So you can just simply say due to unavailability of vacant d orbitals or due to absence of the d orbitals. Now, so next is that the stability of pentahalides decreases down the group, or we can say that the stability of plus 5 state is going to decrease down the group, right? And this is because of inert pair effect mainly. That is inability of NS2 electrons to participate in the covalent bond formation, right? So that means if we take phosphorus, right, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, this is going to be bismuth trifluoride halide will be less stable, or it will be almost unstable thermally. Right, now coming to the hybridization, students. So let us take the example of the phosphorus here. Let it be phosphorus PCl5 or PX5 we have taken. So it undergoes sp3d hybridization, right? And the shape of the molecule is going to be trigonal bipyramidal, right? It will have two types of bond, equatorial and the axial bond, So if we take, this is the P here, right? So, and we have got 5 Cl to arrange. So here, the one plane, equatorial plane, it is in this way. Now all of these are the equatorial bond. These are the equatorial bonds. And the bond angle between the equatorial bond is 120 degree. These are the two other chlorine atoms. This is the axial bond, right? And the bond angle between the axial and the equatorial is, sorry, axial and this one completely is going to be how much, students? 90 degree, right? And the two axial bond are separated through 180 degree. Now, if you see that the bond length of the equatorial bond is less, or we can say that the bond length of axial bond is going to be more than that of equatorial, because of here the repulsion is maximum in axial bond. The repulsion is maximum, right, from the three surrounding equatorial bond. As a result, they will try to stay apart, right? So the repulsion is more in the axial bond. That's why the bond length is maximum here. So you can get a question that why the bond lengths in PCl5 are not all equal. So due to the geometry, we get two types of bonds. One is equatorial bond, another is axial bond, right? The axial bond length is more because of the greater repulsion from the surrounding three equatorial bonds, right? Now students, here one thing more comes is the state. Now generally the pentahalides in the gaseous state, pentahalides in the gaseous state, this is very important student, they exist in the form as a molecule. That means we will get them as a PCl5 molecule, right? But in the crystalline state, that is in the solid state, we get them in the form in this way. That means the two PCl5 molecules nearby, right, they will be in the form ionic state. That is, one is PCl4 plus, another is PCl6 negative. That means one is losing the chlorine atom and other is accepting it, right? And if this is the case, right students, so earlier the shape is trigonal bipyramidal, but later on we get here the shape is getting changed in the crystalline state, right? Square planar and the octahedral geometry, right? And the hybridization will change from sp3d to sp3d2, right, when we get the PCl6 negative ion form, right? So in the crystalline state, on the solid state, the pentahalides, they are in the ionic state.